Welcome to WebStylePress. I am getting questions like how to run PHP file in browser, how to run PHP file in Chrome, how to run PHP file in Windows, how to run PHP file in localhost, how to run PHP file in XAMPP, or how to execute PHP code in general. If you are into PHP or you want to use WordPress for your website or you want to work on Laravel, or any other PHP framework, you will need to know how can you run PHP code on a local machine. If you get a web hosting, upload a PHP file and run it in web browser by calling its address, it will execute PHP code. That is because usually web servers come pre-configured to run PHP code. A web server can handle files with PHP extension. For your local machine, you have to install a local web server or local host to handle PHP files. Install XAMPP or WampServer or WampServer in PC to work with PHP files. Search for WampServer and you will find its website. This is WampServer that comes with PHP, Apache, MySQL databases and PHP MyAdmin. You can download it by the link given here. And this is XAMPP website. It comes with Apache, MariaDB, PHP, and MySQL, and everything you need for PHP web development. You can download it for Windows, for Linux, and for Mac. Get one of these, either WampServer or XAMPP. I have installed XAMPP in my PC, and in third drive, not in C drive. This drive has got operating system. Operating system fails sometimes and I will have to reinstall Windows. So I don't want to lose the files. So I have installed it in E drive. And it's better to install web server in any other drive other than C in general. In case of Windows operating system, it applies strict policies for C drive. So I have installed XAMPP in my E drive. And here I've got this stdocs folder. This is the root folder for this XAMPP server. Here I can place my PHP files or my project folders. Generally, I create a main folder with the name of projects and keep my projects inside this folder. So in one of these folders, I've got this index.php file that is opened in my Visual Studio Code. And here I've got this PHP code. I'm just echoing simple text and PHP info. So this is a PHP file, index.php. To run it, I'll have to fire up this web server. I've installed XAMPP, so I will go to start. I will search for XAMPP, and this is XAMPP control panel. And I will have to start Apache and MySQL services. Start. And now from web browser, I will go to localhost. Go to localhost. And from here, you can browse PHP MyAdmin area. Here, you can create databases. And for the PHP pages, we can navigate to this file in our web server. It's inside projects folder and then WSP1. So we will change this address next to localhost. We will specify this new address, localhost/projects. And I can see my folders here. So WSP1, and here I can see that page and it is being executed here. And I can also call that file directly, index.php. And this is the same page. This is the PHP info. Output for the PHP info, and this is that simple text. So this page is working and this server is running. If I stop these two services, Apache and MySQL, and then refresh this page, then we have stopped the web server. Now this page will not work. So this is how you will execute PHP code in local PC. You install a web server, you start this service, Apache and MySQL, and then MySQL for this PHP, MyAdmin, for databases. And then you will navigate to that page, and then page will execute PHP code. So when you are done working, you should close this web server properly. That is by clicking at this quit button. Click quit button to exit web server. And that's that. So WampServer and XAMPP is the answer. Use any web server from these. Place your PHP file in their root directories. Fire up the server, navigate to those files, and those files will run PHP code or execute PHP code. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.